I did not upload yesterday because I actually had a social life, so it was like, I can either take the time to do a really quick game and not really care about how I narrate at all, or I can upload tomorrow a good game, and that's kind of what we got going on, as you can see by today. But what's up, guys? I have Wednesday's game on Thursday just because I'm a lazy fuck, and it's against one of Heather's friends, and, you know, just based on that, that should probably tell you about how long ago this game was. I think this game's like 2 months old today, give or take a day or two. But we were playing at the bar, and then it turns out that he was one of her only friends that already had level 100s. Good to go, just because you can do flat battle infrared, but Ace Card doesn't have that built in, so it's like, ah, shit, which one are we gonna play? And then Victor had some pokes, and then it was like, okay, so I figured this was during that phase where I was like, let's bring the high bent team, and then we'll see how it's going. So it's very different battling somebody in person because there's body language. You know, if you haven't met them ever, then you don't necessarily know how they're gonna play. I mean, I see Hale, so right off the bat, you know, he probably knows what he's doing. It would have been nice if I could have got an entry hazard set up, you know, bounce that back. I should have suspected better based off of lead Bama's fine, but I was like, I don't know, maybe he suspected something else of mine to lead or some shit like that. And it turns out that all these hazards he's setting up, I have a magic bounce Espeon on my team, and I don't fucking switch it in on any of the hazards at all, and he just gets them all set up. I'm like, okay, I don't know what I'm doing. But I decided to go for disable right now to try to shut down the spikes to prevent him from doing anything, but it turns out he just sets up the one layer. He is knowledgeable of sub-disable Gengar, so this kind of gives me a better gauge, you know, on what kind of player he is. I know he played competitively just based on what I'd been told, but I didn't know, you know, like, how exactly, that kind of thing, if that makes sense. But he whirlwinds me out into Victini. The plays on the screen have been fairly obvious, you know, just a regular tempo, that kind of shit, whatever. But I was like, alright, I'm just gonna stay in, go for V-Create. I don't know if maybe he'll think I'll over-predict or anything like that, but it turns out that that really was the safest play. And I don't really have a lot of room to be switching this Victini in and out, because I don't have any Rapid Spinners. If I'm lucky, I'll be able to get one more switch to this thing, unless I can get a switch from Vaporeon with the Wish Pass to it. Otherwise, you know, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I need to preserve this Victini as long as possible just because it is my Scarfer. And I don't know if he has any Scarfers on his team or anything like that, but I figure I'm just gonna go for another V-Create. And at that point in the game, I was like, I'm just gonna sack this thing. Fuck it, you know. Hazards are just gonna end up ruining my day. But it turns out he has Aqua Ring. Now, Aqua Ring normally carries Baton Pass and that kind of thing. But I still don't know the rest of his set. I do know that a water move is more than likely incoming next turn, though, since he'll want to damage the Victini while it's in. So I'm going to go into Vaporeon both to try to take the water attack and to try to pass a wish out, back out to my Victini. And it turns out, you know, I do predict the water absorb correctly, so the hazards are essentially negated. And we also learned that it does less than 25%, so hey, kind of cool. But he's got Aqua Ring and lefties. So right here, I was like, okay, he'll probably Baton Pass it out now. And it turns out he stays in and goes for the Acid Armor. I don't know if we're like the exact same speed or anything like that, but he went faster, and it turns out that I fucking scald him on the turn that he goes for the Acid Armor, because I truthfully didn't expect him to have that. And I don't know what his fourth move is at this point, but you know, if it's Aqua Ring, it's more likely gonna end up being Baton Pass. What this tells me right off the bat is that he's a mono attacking set, which means that if I can keep this Vaporeon alive until his Vaporeon is one of the only things left on the field, that's gonna give me a lot more leeway in terms of what I can do with this game. But he passes out into Skarm, which has lefties and Aqua Ring going on, and he's just gonna continue setting up hazards. You know, the only thing I really wanna do right now is scald this thing to get a burn to negate the lefties and the Aqua Ring, and after turn effects is really probably a bitch for you guys. I don't know why I didn't speed this up too much, but see, lefties, Aqua Ring, I don't get the Scald Burn, but at least the turns are going by pretty quick, so there's not really a whole lot of damage or anything like that. But go for a Scald now. I believe I get a crit on this one, which based on the damage from the other one, definitely fucking matter, but it happens right after he gets all three layers of spikes set up anyway, so that Victini is good for one more hit, tops, and that's about it. But he finally brings in his Weather Inducer on this turn, and I'm just gonna go for a Toxic. I don't know what it wants to do, I don't know what build it is, I was just like, you know what, I'm gonna fucking go for a Toxic. If he goes for a sub, that'll kind of suck. I don't really know what I would have done with it. I was like, okay. But off the top of my head, I guess I thought about it, and I was like, you know, maybe it'll fucking work. Maybe he's just bringing this thing to go for his weather, and then I don't know what from there. But Subseed is a fairly popular set, so that play was really, 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 really risky, is what I'm trying to say. But I go for Protect, just to rack up some Toxic damage and see what else he wants to do. It's probably going to be Sub, Leech Seed, Blizzard, and then fucking, I don't know, energy ball, something like that. Maybe dual stab, or, you know, maybe he's got some weird-ass HP fire or something going on. But I'm going to go for a wish, just so I can attempt to pass it off. And since he's going to go ahead and leech seed me, I really do not give a shit, just because I'm going to be out of here anyway. But I'm going to try to pass it off to Victini, I believe, just to get some HP back. I haven't seen this match in a while, so if I pass it to something else, fucking whatever. All I know is near endgame, the after-turn effects get so brutal, I just had to speed it up. A lot. And I'd watch this game a lot when it happened, but truthfully, I haven't seen it since like a month ago. But I'm switching out now, and it turns out I do decide to pass it out into Victini. I guess I'm going to go for the U-turn or something like that, or I don't know. But as you can see, hazards just are unbearable, and it turns out he has Focus Punch. I don't know why I didn't expect that. You know, he had Sub, he had Leech Seed. I don't know, Subseeders, I don't really expect him to have Focus Punch, but if Bombasnow's got big arms, it makes sense. Fortunately, you know, the Leech Seed is gone, and Toxic Damage is racking up a little bit, but I have lost my Choice Scarfer, and that really sucks. At least Gengar can come in, he only takes Stealth Rock's damage though, so I'm gonna go for the Sub, just to see what he's gonna end up doing, and it turns out he's just gonna end up going for Blizzard, that's whatever. Maybe at this point I was... Oh, you know what, I'm trying to Substall him, until he decides to switch. So I guess that kind of makes sense, but I can only do it for maybe two more turns if my math is correct. I don't know how well I was thinking about this, but let's see how low it brings him. It'll kind of be a game of chicken if he wants to keep it in or if he wants to die the next turn. I think he will die next turn to the toxic damage after all that shit. You know, if he had Baton Pest Aqua Ring out to this thing, that would have helped a lot. After turn effects would have been brutal as well, but... as you can see, I'm not good for a sub on this next turn just because I'm already like red to yellow health. I'll die to hail next turn, or I won't be able to make one on this turn. But I'm pretty sure, based on the last turn, that toxic damage is going to take him out. And it does. So, finally get a kill. I don't know what I'm going to do with this. So, in comes Stalrein. I mean, Walrein. No, I definitely meant Stalrein, trust me. This Protect struck me as a little weird, just because he doesn't really benefit from it at all. I mean, I'm negating the hail with my lefties. I guess he's maybe just trying to burn off a Focus Blast PowerPoint or whatever the fuck I was going to try to do. Now here, I predict the Frost Last come in. I remember this exact fucking moment. He was trying to coax me into going for it again. I said, no sir, I'm going to switch to Shadow Ball on this turn, just because I do suspect that happening. And it takes him out, you know, no fucking Snow Cloak for this Frost Last, no nothing, and there we go. So I finally have a read on him, and more or less, and I've finally taken out two pokes. So score's kind of evening up, but he does have a shit ton of entry hazard, so switches are going to have to be minimal. And it turns out that I missed my Focus Blast here, but he wears me out, so I actually get to hold on to this Gengar, not for too long, but hey. So in comes Espeon, way too late to the party, you know, getting hurt by these entry hazards and shit all the time. Or just not all the time. What? That made zero sense. God, I felt like Michael Scott right there. Anyways, what I got going on is a fucking HP fighting for this Walrein. If it was HP fire, that would have been stupid, but HP fighting does do a good amount of damage. And I believe he's gonna try to protect right here just to get that ice body and shit going on. Ice body lefties, it's a pretty synergetic team, especially if you can pass Aqua Ring out to it, because then that way, you know, it gets three, like fucking, what is it, 3/16 of its health back per turn. But he's gonna go ahead and protect right here just to get some more HP back. I am going to go for a Calm Mind so I can actually take a couple of his Blizzards, because if he's invested, you know, defensively, I should be able to take a couple of these. Not too many, but it'll be at the point where if I get one more Calm Mind, HP fighting will do a substantial amount more to him once I'm able to break this sub down. And this is a Calm Mind 3 attacking set for anyone that's unfamiliar with it. I'm just gonna go for another one. And I think he actually tries roaring himself, but that's what ends up happening because of Magic Bounce. But I don't know, like, I looked at him during the game, and I was like, that's what's gonna end up happening if you go for it. And it's just a completely fucking random switch based on that. But I can go ahead and HP fighting this thing now instead, and I won't have to worry about protects or anything like that. The thing I do have to fucking worry about is Snowcloak, because I miss my HP fighting, and he hits a Stone Edge. And I'm just sitting at the table, like, you just Magic Bounce roared yourself out into something that killed me off because of a Snowcloak miss. You know what I have to say to that? I have Machamp. And you know what he has to say to Snowcloak and this Earthquake, by the way? Fuck you. That's what he has to say. He's gonna live this Earthquake. Kinda surprised me, truthfully. But Dynamic Punch, you know, thanks to No Guard, will not miss. His Stone Edge will not miss, but he went for Earthquake anyway, just because of the stab. Truthfully, I think he should have gone for Icicle Crash if he had it, just because he did have odds of flinching, but I guess he kind of expected Earthquake to kill. I kind of expected it to kill too, but hey, you know, we take it out with a surefire hit, and I don't have to worry about fucking stalling shit or anything like that at all, but he's going to go for another Protect, and it turns out that all these Ice types on his team, you know, I took out Frostless earlier, so I don't have to worry about the fighting immunity, but this is working out pretty good. You know, I just get to punch a lot of things in the face, and I'm definitely going to end up being faster than a Walrus. Come on, who are we kidding? So, he doesn't try to protect on this turn. I don't know why he tried protecting. Like, Walrein is not going to take a Dynamic Punch, if at all. And much to my surprise, he actually does. You know, he's invested very defensively, and I believe he hits himself in confusion here. So, just to put salt into the wound, he lives with red, and he finishes himself off, and this Machamp is somehow still alive. It really shouldn't be. I don't know. I don't know what the damage calc on that Mamoswine was, but I shouldn't be alive. So, he sends in Vaporeon, which he definitely should have done a long time ago. I guess he expected this thing to be slower, which is why he sent in all these other things before it. But he's faster, and he just ends up finishing me off right here. Now, going back to the situation I was talking about earlier with the mono-attacking Vaporeon, my Vaporeon has Toxic. His does not. Meaning that we are at a stalemate here, especially if this is his last one, and I do believe this is his last one. So he can go for Aqua Ring all he wants. But the thing is, he's got Aqua Ring, he's got lefties, there's hail, there's toxic damage happening, and as you can see, this part is sped up. But this is basically my game. The instant I can land a condition, that kind of thing, I believe I went for a couple wishes. I also still have Scizor lying in the wings. Did I mention that? No, I didn't. But as you can see, Baton Pass fails because this is his last one. And I was like, can you just run at this point? And he just looked at me and I was like, I'm not running. I was like, okay, that kind of thing, I understand. But I decided to go into my Scizor because I have Roost on this guy too. And I figure I'll just pass off a wish. This is getting really fucking old really fucking quick. But he can go for Acid Armors. I can go for Swords Dances. And I do not only have Bullet Punch, I have Bug Bite as well. So it'll be plus 6 defense versus plus 6 attack. On top of that, we have, you know, we have toxic damage adding up. And look at all these afterturn effects, dude. This is ridiculous. This is pretty bad. And I'm a special defensive Scizor too, but on the turn that Toxic was supposed to kill him, he motherfucking runs, and he doesn't even give me that dignity. So I pouted at him a long time, but it was a good game. I had a lot of fun with it, minus the last like 10 or 12 turns, which, believe me, they were painstaking in real time. I watched my drinks ice melt during that. And that was an excellent segue into it because, you know, I took down the Hail team. So, hey, that's kind of cool. If you guys enjoyed that game, you are able to rate, comment, and subscribe if you would so choose. Do your thing, that kind of thing. I got TCGO coming up after this. I just decided to record this right now. I got a couple other things to record too. And, yeah, look out in your sub boxes for that. And I will see you guys later.